Dr. Daisy. Crash! Boom! Poor Goofy. He tripped over his own feet walking into the clubhouse. Mickey went to see if he was all right. I think so, said Goofy. He checked his knee, his elbow, and his nose. Ow, he said. There's a boo-boo on my nose. Did someone say boo-boo? Asked Daisy. She gently blew on Goofy's nose to make it feel better, and it worked. I want to be the best pretend doctor in the whole world, said Daisy. Mickey and Goofy said they'd help. Mickey turned the clubhouse into a make-believe clinic and brought in three pretend patients. Dr. Daisy's pretend clinic was open. The first patient was Pluto. He had a pretend thorn in his paw. Daisy needed something to pull it out. Oh, Toodles, called Mickey. Toodles had three mouse-ka-tools to choose from, a giraffe, a magnifying glass, and tweezers. The tweezers were just what the doctor ordered. Daisy pulled out the pretend thorn, and then the puppy happily trotted off. Minnie was Dr. Daisy's next patient. I'm pretending to have a tummy ache, she said. There's only one thing for a pretend tummy ache, said Dr. Daisy. A green apple. Mickey knew that there was an apple tree, but how would he reach the fruit? Oh, Toodles. This time, Mickey picked the giraffe, who was easily tall enough to pick an apple. But the giraffe ate everything he picked. Mickey climbed up the giraffe's neck and grabbed the last green apple. Minnie took one bite and felt much better. Thank you, Dr. Daisy, she said. And you, too, Mickey. The last patient of the day was Pete. I've got spotty spots everywhere, he said. He sure did. There were large yellow spots all over his overalls. I need to get a closer look, said Daisy. There was one mouse-ka-tool left, the magnifying glass. Daisy saw that the spots had pictures of chickens on them. Ah! Pete had got pretend chicken pox. To get rid of the pretend chicken pox, you have to do the chicken dance, said Dr. Daisy. Pete danced like a wild chicken, and all the spots fell off. You're a genius, he told Daisy. Everyone agreed.